So there's the good doctor. Let's talk to him. Turn in our quest. Get our experience points. And now it's time to kill some skags, but not after we loot some items here. It's probably my favorite part of this game, is just grabbing all the items, enjoying. There's actually a mailbox over here I want to open. Just because there's actually many challenges, and it's fun to open mailboxes and, you know, commit federal offenses all the time. I mean, you gotta give me credit there. Let's see, do we actually get to go out of the gate here, or... I think we might. I think we actually have to follow the claptrap. Yep. I do not like that, but, you know, it is what it is. You gotta stay in his vicinity, and here they come, shooting at him. We actually have to help him out here real quick. Or maybe not. Where am I getting shot from? Oh, hello. You're now gonna get destroyed because you hurt Mr. Claptrap. That's not a good thing. I do like repeaters, though. Repeaters are always good things. There we go. I think we dealt with them. Maybe not. Maybe not quite yet. There we go. Okay. We have to help this guy now, though. Let's see if we can... Oh, boy. It's over here, by the way. You have to get this Claptrap rescue. It's not that difficult. As you can see, it's right there. I do remember the opening very well, because I've played through it a bunch of times. So, without further ado, we can repair the Claptrap. And we'll kind of continue on our way here. I'm surprised that there is no health regen, but that is okay. It's a sad thing, though. Open up the door for me, though, and I'll be able to continue our skag quest. You can see we're going in a skag gully in the Firestone. There's a bunch of skag over here, and this is actually the place of one of the missions that we have to do eventually anyway, so let's aggro some skag grows here and take them out here. The skags are an interesting bunch of dog-like creatures. They spit at you, and they come and jump and bite at you, as you can see. He's coming on his way here. If he got close enough to me, he would have killed me. And by kill me, I mean he would have just done some damage to me. Good thing about that is, eventually when they open up their mouths to spit at you or bite at you, you can do crits to them. And that's another system in this game, is a critical system. You probably saw it when I was shooting off the heads of some of the bullies, the bandits, I mean, and... you gotta aim for the head and other sensitive areas of the bodies. You'll see them later. Look how happy he is. You can see that later. And it's actually nice. I think it doubles the damage, if not triples, depends. I don't remember exactly, but it's a good thing. It's a very good thing. Now, we have to do a bunch of different quests here, which is really easy. I do remember this one, too. This is just another run and grab an object quest. Not a big deal. Let's see. Telling us how to use our maps here. The casual tutorial is casual, which is kind of nice. They kind of give it to you over a steady period of time, which is kind of nice. And after that, we can purchase a shield, which will protect our health from getting destroyed, as you can see. And I don't think there's any skag that spawn here. Yes, there is, as you can see. Right there in that cave. There's a skag right here. Yep. You're dead, you're done. You're done. Let's get this guy here, finish him off. Nice. You do actually want to vary some of the different weapons you do use, because I will show you this in a second. There's our skill tree. As you can see, there's weapon proficiencies, and the higher the proficiencies are, the more damage, reload speed, etc. are done. So you kind of want to do that. And here's our power coupling right here. Grab it from this old vending machine, and you can go back and repair the one back in Firestone, which is good. As I said, it will lead us to our shield. Good thing about the shield is that once the shield is taken down, it will recharge, so as long as you save your health, your shield will always recharge it, and you will never die. But we will probably be dying plenty of times in this Let's Play, so don't you worry, guys. We will be all dandy and well and good, and we have to fix this machine. There we go. Put that right there. And now we need to buy our first shield. Let's see. They're all the same, so don't worry about what you're buying. Unless you get the daily deal. But we cannot get the daily deal. We don't have enough money. Which is sad, but there is our shield. right there above our health, and you'll see it will regen. You have a shield. Damage inflicted upon you will be first removed from the shield. Your shield goes down and recharge after a short time, but be on the lookout for stronger shields, of course. Shields get ridiculously high, because enemy damage does get ridiculously high as well. So we need to go out and now kill some bandits. See, sorry about the lag. We need to sort of win back the Firestone, if you know what I mean. We need to win back this town and slowly gain territory here. And they keep referencing this Nine Toes, who is like the god, not the god, like the mob boss type person of the area here. I'm actually going to run down and grab this chest. Want to know why? Because I don't care. So let's grab that. $29, it's better than nothing. Let's run up here. They're all up in this encampment here. It's really nice and easy to kill. Kind of looking out for more skags here, but there we are. Stab them. I do like your melee weapon. I do not like running down this gully. Literally the skag gully. Kind of want to get back up there. There we are. Hello, Mr. Skag. You're dead now. I wish my reload speed was a little bit faster. See, we already aggroed the bandits. Now they're starting to shoot at us. Not cool, man. Not cool. But whatever. I will do away with you just like all my other foes. Let's take out my repeater here. Finish him off. There's a nice little critical. And you will notice, too, that some enemies also have shields. So you have to be quite mindful of that as well. Let's shoot this guy in the chest here. Get some repeater points. There you go. Ooh, that was a nice one. Kind of want to go for crits, but the accuracy is a little bit wonky on without a mouse here, which is kind of a shame, but it is what it is. Let's run in here with our AR, so to speak. So to speak, it's not a figure of speech. It's an assault rifle. Why am I like half freezing? That's weird. Oh well. Shoot at these guys. Hey, come here. There we go. There we go. And I hit you in the head. No, I shoot you in the head instead. That's a good thing. Let's finish up this encampment here. Oh shit, we're already losing health. Oh, you gotta strafe it. You gotta strafe it when in doubt. Okay, did not mean to do that, but that is okay. Shoot these guys. Oh, there's a guy behind me too. Man, we really stumbled upon a nice little group of guys here. Nice. There we go. But there we go. And of course, I'm going to be very anal about everything. I apologize. I do collect everything I find on the ground, even though sometimes it just doesn't matter. But it must be done, and there's a weapon chest over there I kind of want to grab, so just give me... Bear with me. It's not a weapon chest. It's, there's an ammo chest right here. I think it has weapons in it, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, there we go. We get our first shotgun there, and we have ourselves another repeater. Got more damage, less fire rate. Don't want it. But what we can end up going and selling it. We can end up going and selling it. Excuse my English, and it's not that bad of a deal, so it's nice and easy, and I think we can just go right back and turn it in. We have nothing else to do because it's the beginning of the game. It's never a bad thing, actually. It is never a bad thing. And there's our depot. You don't have to worry about that until a little bit later. You will see the system. I will not spoil it, because there's another whole element to this game that is just awesomeness. And I believe the bounty board will be up and running. Maybe not. This will be the bounty board. You'll see that in a second. Once we do a couple more quests with Dr. Zed here. But for now, he's going to be the main XP giver to us, which is never a bad thing. Now we got to go talk to TK Baha, who's a pretty cool guy. Let's actually sell these weapons really quick that I don't need. Which ones don't I need? This one I definitely do not need. What's this one? I think that's the one I actually have. Yeah, fire rate, accuracy's down. Actually, I'm going to sell that one. Oh no, those are the ones I have equipped. That's good. Let's see. Do I need this shotgun really? No, but I don't need that, that's for sure. Let's see what the item of the day is. Better shield, but slow health regen. I don't want it. Let's go out now. Meet Mr. TK Baha. He will come into play, I think, later in the game as well. I don't want to like get ahead of myself. You have to be careful of that in these Let's Plays, because everything sort of plays off each other. This mishmash of a game. So it gets very chaotic later, you will see. The plot actually gets fairly awesome. And as you can see, we've already angered bandits just by killing some of their own. So you have to deal with them. I think I actually will level up for killing this guy. Or come close to it, at least. Oh my gosh, I can't hit him because of the accuracy. There we go. One of his friends is behind there. But we're going to leave that alone here. Hopefully we don't aggro any skags that come and hit me from behind, because they get really long ranges of jumping. No, we didn't. Good, that's good. Let's actually rummage around in his... I don't think there's actually anything in here. Oh, there is. Rummage around in his little apartment area first.
You! One more step and it'll be your last! You should have seen the look on your face!
Well, just for that comment, I'm going to steal whatever's in your little fishing box here. I guess we can't go in his house quite yet. Let's talk to him. Excuse me, sorry. There we go! I think we leveled up. Maybe not. Oh, but we gotta give him some food, though. Yes, we did level up. Awesome. As you can see, when you level up, you get upgrades to your health and such, and those are never a bad thing. Let's go in his toilet here. Thank you for the shotgun ammo. That was very nice of you to give me. And money, just laying around every which way. What the heck? What are you doing on his property, man? You just saw him stick a shotgun up in my face, so... I mean, that, of all things, would be sort of a warning. But that's okay. This is actually a very quick quest that we can do. We're kind of grooving through this first part of the game. There's really nothing out to do here. You really don't want to farm just yet. I mean, there's, like, places you can do that at, but normally you can just... Oh, we angered a bunch of them here. Hold on. Let's make sure we can get them all here. They're just pups, though. And there's not really many powerful enemies in this part, as you can see. Just skags and skags and skags and skags. There's a lot more bandits in different areas once we get there, but we gotta get there first, so... That's why we gotta get through these grindy-type quests first. Let me just hop up in there. There we go. Get some nice ammo from that. Hello! You have escaped my view, but not for long. Nice another thing about this game is that you can run while reloading, which is just beautiful. I wish every game was like this, because it makes everything so much easier. And there's another piece of food right here, because we wiped out two nests. There's always one piece of food per nest, so things move quite quickly, as you can see. There's one right here, which we're going to grab, and there's another right to the right of that. If you could not see it, it is right where I'm facing right now. You can see it right above the skag whelp, which is spelled with a WH, which surprises me, actually, because I didn't think that would be spelled like that. That's okay. You're dead. You're done. Let's run up here and finish off this last skag here. As you can see, the enemy's levels in different areas scale up with you, so it's not... you know, you're not running over people. There's going to be points in time where I'm the one that's lower leveled and everyone is mashing on me, so you have to be careful with that stuff, which is always why you want to do all the quests. I'm not sure if I'm going to do every single quest, but I'm certainly going to do a healthy amount of them, because it really does help with your levels, and in turn that just makes the game a little bit easier, and it'll probably save time later because I won't be dying as much. Right, thank you for the ammo, sir. I love that repeater, though. I don't think I'm going to be very shotgun-heavy, because you don't get many good shotguns, you know, until, like, later and in the DLCs, etc. Just something you got to think about here. I think we can go into his house after this mission, actually. Turn that in. I should actually start reading these mission things.